such a good idea to come here. Look at my fork.
Ew. Ew, it's not a good neighborhood, but believe me, the food is very good.
And what's that awful smell?
Ew!
Well, look, our table's right next to the bathroom.
It's not the bathroom, it's the kitchen.
Ew! Ooh, doesn't the food look good?
Hi, my name is Lanford. Who gets the mussels?
Ew, I didn't order mussels.
Oh, no, I ordered the mussels. But, can I change my order? It's got all these little black dots in it.
You can't change the order. The cook just cut off his thumb and he went home.
Well, all right. Well, I'll take it. But I ordered the catch of the day.
Oh, I wouldn't try that.
Well, you advised me to order this, so just bring me the catch of the day, all right?
Very well.
Ew! I just stuck my sleeve in the food and there's honey all over it.
Ew!
Any of you know that honey is really bee vomit?
Bee vomit? Ew! Ew, I think I have something in my shoe.
Ew, Jerome, don't shake your shoe over the table.
Can I finish your cheese?
That's not cheese, that's butter.
Ew!
Ew, I bit my tongue. Is it bleeding?
Ew, don't open your mouth with food in it like that.
Ew, something fell out.
I didn't see it. Ew, do it again.
Ew!
I think I'm having an allergic reaction to these mussels. My chest feels all funny.
Ew!
Does that mean I could have your mussels? This isn't a mussel. It's a thumb.
Ew!
You order the catch of the day. Tête du jour.
A human head!
Ooh. Ooh, it's the new show.
Good evening, and welcome to The New Show. Tonight, starring Valerie Bromfield, Buck Henry, Raul Julia, Penny Marshall, and Dave Thomas. Musical guest, Randy Newman.
Ladies and gentlemen, Penny Marshall.
Because it is the new show, I thought I'd try to do something different. It's the latest craze in New York, breakdancing. Yeah. I guess some of you know what breakdancing is, huh?
Yeah.
Would any of you like to trade places with me?
Yeah?
Okay. Well, before I introduce the guys that I'm going to dance with, I would like you to know in order to get into this group, you have to jump off the Chrysler Building and land on your neck. Ladies and gentlemen, the Dynamic Breakers.
Yeah.
Cronkite's World of Bloopers.
And now, here's Walter.
Good evening. This is Walter Cronkite. You may not have seen much of me since I left CBS News several years ago. My show, Universe, was a flop. But now I'm back with Walter Cronkite's World of Bloopers, and happy to be back. Tonight, we'll take another look at some of the flubs and blunders from America's top TV personalities. Join me now as we take a look at them.
Hey, Fred, what time should Betty and I come over for dinner tonight?
Well, Barney, Wilma's got the brontosaurus buns bobbing, boobin'.
Is that in the script, Fred?
Take two.
Well, Barney, Wilma's buns are,
Wilma's buns, Fred?
Jane, I'm home, and I can't for the life of me remember my next line.
Take two.
Jane, I'm home, and I can't see you. A little help with the door, please.
Rubble, come out of there, you back-bee-boom.
Fred?
Yeah, what?
The line is big baboon.
Oh. That, of course, was Fred Flintstone in the last scene, caught in the act of a blooper. Now please welcome with me, the First Lady. I made a little blooper there myself. Perhaps I'll save that for next week's show. And now please welcome the First Lady of Bedrock, Wilma Flintstone.
Well, hello, Walter.
Wilma, I must say you look a lot more realistic in person than you do in the cartoons.
Oh, well, thank you, Walter. And you know, in person, you look much more like a cartoon.
Well, I guess we're even. Tell us, what is Fred Flintstone really like to work with?
Oh, he's hilarious. You know, Fred is a great practical joker and quite a talented little mimic. You know, the other week, he played a little practical joke on Barney, which our cameras just happened to catch.
A practical joke on Barney Rubble, played by Fred Flintstone. Let's take a look.
Hello, Barney. This is Dustin Hoffman speaking. I happen to be a big fan of yours.
Quiet down, everybody. I've got Dustin Hoffman on the line. I'm a big fan of yours, too, Mr. Hoffman.
Listen, Barney, you just have to co-star with me in my next movie. Think about it, okay?
Well, gee, I think I can.
Barney, it's Fred.
Hey, what is this, something for Cronkite Stupid Blooper Show?
Truth, Wilma, I don't understand why Americans are so caught up with these blooper shows to begin with. They're nothing but a celebration of mediocrity from performers who can't read simple words on a page.
Oh, come on, Walter, let your hair down. Here, have a Bronto burger.
Well, that's not a blooper, but it's the end of the show. This is Walter Cronkite saying goodnight, everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, my good friend, Randy Newman.
My wife and I took a little trip down to Mexico. Met this young girl there. We brought her back with us. Now she lives with us in our home. She cleans the hallway. She cleans the stairs. She cleans the living room. She wipes the babies. She drives the kids to school. She does the laundry too. She wrote this song for me. Listen. Yeah, another afternoon. My wife and I took a little ride into Beverly Hills. Went to the private school our oldest child attends. Many famous people send their children there. This teacher says to us, we have a problem. problem here. This child just will not do the thing we tell him to. He's such a big old thing. He hurts the other children. And all the games they play, he plays too rough. I said, hold it, teacher. Wait a minute. Maybe my ears are clogged or something. Maybe I'm not understanding the English language. Dear, you don't seem to realize my life is good. My life is good, you old bag. My life is good. My life just this evening, some young associates of ours flying in to see us from New York City. They're gonna stay with us a couple weeks or so. I'm gonna take them to restaurants and everything. I'm gonna get them some real good. They don't get much where they come from. This one guy's wife's such a pretty little brown thing. I'm liable to give her a poke or two. What do you think of that? Teacher, let me tell you a little story. Just this morning, my wife and I went to this hotel in the hills. That's right, the Bel Air Hotel, where a very good friend of ours happens to be staying. And the name of this young man is Mr. Bruce Springsteen. That's right. We talked about some kind of woodblock or something, and this new guitar we like. And you know what he said to me? I'll tell you what he said to me. He said, Rand, I'm tired. How would you like to be the boss for a while? Well, yeah. My life is good. My life
Scarface is here to see you.
No, don't let her in.
I
You boss everybody else around. You can't boss me around. Ah! Scarface! Look at all this stuff.
What stuff?
What stuff? That stuff.
Oh, this stuff. Oh, mama, this is just a little, you know, dust. The green lady didn't come today.
Give her money.
Oh, no. Don't give me money. I don't want your daughter money. And don't you let your sister in here. If she see all this stuff, she do some of it. And you, what kind of a wife are you doing all this stuff?
This stuff?
Don't you ever hit my mother.
Yes.
Senora Scarface, it's your sister.
My little pig. I love you, my darling, my sweet. I love you.
I told you not to come here.
Darling, you killed my husband.
I did?
Yes, you did. You died, brother.
I am shot in the belly by my own little sister. You're right, I am doing too much of that stuff.
All right, everybody, freeze! Federal Bureau of Narcotics. Okay, Scarface, it looks like we've caught you red-handed, huh? Hey, this isn't cocaine, it's flour.
Flour? Cocaine? You know how much this much cocaine would cost?
Wait a minute. Isn't this Scarface, the motion picture?
No, this is Scarface, the TV show.
Oh. Well, in that case, want some flour, boys?
Sure, yeah. Yeah. Come on.
We just had some fun. But as many of you know, the film Scarface wasn't a comedy. And cocaine is no laughing matter. It's a very serious activity whose consequences, in addition to prison and disrupted lives, can even be fatal. If you take drugs, the laugh is on you.
Once again, it's weekend tonight with those two celebrated world travelers who go everywhere and know everyone and never let a weekend go to waste. Buck Henry and Dave Thomas.
Hello, I'm Buck Henry.
And I'm Dave Thomas.
And welcome to Weekend Tonight. Dave, what's new? What's hot?
Hot? Well, Buck, red-hot singing sensation Michael Jackson became even hotter this week when his hair accidentally caught fire during the filming of a Pepsi commercial. The superstar was not seriously hurt, but he has decided to make a minor change in his image. Instead of the glittery silver oversized glove that has become his trademark, Mr. Jackson will be wearing this oven mitt so that he can quickly pat out any future bodily blazes.
Well, it sounds like an excellent idea to me, Dave. You know, for all of us who were devastated when Laverne and Shirley went off the air last May, there's some great news.
Right you are, Buck. The American Broadcasting Company has decided to resurrect this successful series, but this time around, Penny Marshall's sidekick will be former First Lady Jacqueline Kennedy Onassis. We visited the set of Laverne and Jackie just in time to see them tape a scene from their pilot episode.
That's it, Jackie. Take it easy. Watch it.
Okay. Oh, you know, the first time I had moose was with the Duchess of Kent. I was in a small...
Yeah, well, this isn't moose, Jackie. It's chocolate pudding.
Oh, my emerald, the world's largest. I must have...
Oh, no, Jackie, don't say you dropped it in the pudding.
Oh, no, and it was the one I got at Pablo Picasso's birthday.
Okay, don't cry. We'll find it. We'll just find it. Okay. It's in here somewhere. Okay, look, just don't stand there. Help me.
Oh, but Penny, we heard you were tired of doing Laverne.
Well, that's true, Dave. You do get tired of doing the same character over and over, but when the opportunity arises to work with one of your childhood idols...
Jackie!
That's right. She is so funny, Buck, I can't begin to tell you. She cracks the crew up all the time.
Now, Jackie, you've been Jacqueline Bouvier, Jacqueline Kennedy Onassis, Jackie O, but now you're just half of Laverne and Jackie. How come?
Oh, well, Buck, I think I'm most humorous as just Jackie.
She is so funny. Go ahead, make that fish face.
Oh,
make.
No, no.
Come on.
Oh, come
Jackie,
on.
Make that
yeah.
fish face.
Do the face.
Well, thank you, girls, for taking time out of your busy schedule
to talk to us on Weekend Tonight.
Yes.
And good luck with your
series. Oh, that Jackie. I think she can do a series herself.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Dave, going from the ridiculous to the sublime, television's cultural highlight of the year took place last week.
Obviously, you're talking about the production of Sir Laurence Olivier's King Lear.
Exactly right. And I found the great actor himself in his dressing room, and he agreed to talk to us.
I'm Buck Henry from Weekend Tonight.
I'm Lord Olivier's dresser.
Oh, I... Could Lord Olivier talk to me for a couple of minutes?
Hey, Larry, there's a guy here to see you.
Sir Larry, how do you prepare for a part in which your actual own persona is so hidden?
I learn my lines, which is something so many players, young players today, do not do. And then I'm on time. I don't bump into the furniture. And I leave at lunch promptly with everyone else.
They say that a great actor like yourself can hold an audience in the palm of his hand by doing something as banal as reading from the telephone book.
Well, of course, that's been done, hasn't it?
Yes.
I might read from a vitamin bottle, perhaps. Excuse, I must use these glasses.
Can't see the way
I used to be able to. This is the natural whole complex lecithin as processed from edible soybean, the raw, crude, natural phosphatide and fatty acid complex. It differs from the granule products in that none of the fatty acids has been removed. Nothing has been taken away. All of the natural factors are retained.
Amazing. I wonder, sir, if it's possible for you as a master of dialects and accents to give us an example of that subtle distinction you made in those two films, The Boys from Brazil and Marathon Man, between the old German and the old Jew. Could you say the line... I think I'm going to go out and go to the store, like the old Jew.
I think I'm going to go out and go to the store.
And as the old German?
I think I'm going to go out and go to the store.
Wow. My fantasy would be to perform on the Shakespearean stage with you, to be able to play the fool to your King Lear.
Well, of course, the volume and the power of my voice might flatten you. You might not be prepared for this.
I'm willing to try.
Well, very well. Brace yourself. Blow, winds, and crack your cheeks. Rage, blow, you cataracts and hurricanes. Smoke! Buck?
Buck? Uncle, pretty good uncle, let us go then to the heath and find the thing itself.
You sulphurous and hot executing fire, rock couriers of unpleasing thunderbolts, singe my white hair!
Yes, uncle!
Crack nature's mold! That old German spirit was...
What an actor. What a guy.
Well, Buck, you certainly made a proper fool of yourself, and I must say Lord Larry blew you right off the stage.
Well, right you are, Dave, but I'm telling you, it was well worth it. And now, Weekend Tonight is proud to slavishly follow the lead of so many popular magazines in offering our version of What's In, What's Out. Dave, what's on this week's list?
Well, Buck, this week rock videos are in and educational film strips are out. The new word processors are in, but Soviet mimeograph machines are out.
Mm-hmm. This week, tunneling out of prison is out, but sneaking out of prison dressed as a woman is in. 1983 calendars are out. 1984 calendars are in.
Traditional marriage is in again, but taking the widows of your slain enemies as concubines is out. And finally, Barbra Streisand is in, but Isaac Bashevis Singer is out. I'm sorry, that's the way it is.
Dave, do you know what yesterday was?
Yes, it was February 2nd, Groundhog Day.
That's right. And Dave, this is one of the most bizarre stories I've ever covered. I think I'll let the report speak for itself.
It's a pretty cold day in the park, but it's February 2nd, and time for that groundhog to come out, and as tradition has it, if he doesn't see the sun, he comes out and has a good time. If he sees the sun and his shadow, he goes back in and sleeps for another 6 weeks, which would make me pretty angry if I had to go back in a hole like this and sleep for another 6 weeks. My goodness, there's the groundhog now. And isn't he a big one? Let's just see if we can get some zoological musings from him. Well, Mr. Groundhog, hey, you're a pretty big fella. Oh, large and claws! Look out! Kids, you better get out. Better get out. Run for it! Look out! Look out! He's coming this way!
He went for the airport, Dave. He took a JAL plane to Japan. I don't know why, but the reports so far say that he's marauding all over Japan. People are running, screaming. They begin to refer to him as Groundzilla. It's one of the most terrifying international experiences I think we've ever seen. And I just don't know.
Wait a minute. Stop it. Stop the film, please. Stop it. Please stop. In the control room, stop the film. Buck, what do you think you're doing?
What do you mean?
I mean, dressing up someone in a cheap groundhog costume and doing an even cheaper editing job with some two-bit Japanese horror film footage? Why would you stoop to this?
Okay, you've properly humiliated me. But I will say this in my defense.
All right, let's hear it.
It's topical.
Well, I can't argue with you there. And speaking of topical, last Sunday night, Ronald Reagan announced that he would seek re-election. And he started his campaign this very evening by giving an inspirational address to all the important people in Washington.
Well, here are the photographs I promised you of myself, Dip.
Now, I'll get the projector and turn the lights down. Whenever you're ready with the film, you'll cue me. Is that all right?
Well, that'll be just fine.
Hello, sir. Please excuse my palms. They're clammy.
I like clammy palms. Well, I hope they like the movie.
Wave your hand, sir.
Hi, everyone. Some days when life seems hard and we reach out for values to sustain us or a friend to help us, we find a person who reminds us what it means to be Americans. And, of course, I'm talking about myself, so please watch the big TV screen. Remember the old P-40s? Well, I was flying around in one of them, just having a happy day, when suddenly I spotted something. Well, it looked awful small, but then again it was far away. Was it one of ours or one of theirs? Oh, well, no matter. Either way, it had no right to be flying there with me. This was World War II, don't forget. So I tipped into a tight barrel roll, sped up to 470 miles an hour in a 9G power dive, and decided to take her out. Theirs, ours, friend or foe, one man and only one man was going to walk away from this. It was kind of exhilarating to watch him fall from the sky. And I had this sickening thought. Well, it could have been me. Oh, well, it wasn't. Well, the lesson is, I think, to always look out for number one.
That's right. Absolutely right, Ron. And you'll always be number one with us.
And so will you, folks. Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Nine days to passion. Nine days to glory. Nine days to murder. All in the first degree. Three friends. One will kill, one will die, and only one will survive when the truth finally explodes. Nine days to celebrity.
News 8 Update.
Good evening, I'm Kathy Smith. If you're looking for a temporary job, head out to Portland Meadows this weekend. Hundreds of people will be hired for a 42-day racing season. A verdict tonight in the trial of a Springfield woman who was charged in the car bombing death of her husband. And another Oregon bank has failed. Emerald Empire Bank of Springfield will be taken over by an Albany bank. Complete details on News 8 tonight at 11.
We're rebuilding a bigger, more modern Ronkonkoma Chevrolet Honda out 122nd Way to serve you better than ever before. We're raising the roof, we're lowering prices out 122nd Way.
That dress is irresistible.
So is your Aramis.
I have an idea. Why don't you go in and say goodnight all, time to go home?
Oh, that's brilliant.
Yes.
Only nobody's gotten here yet.
Nobody?
The Aramis umbrella. Your gift with any $10 purchase of Aramis, Devon, or Aramis 900. Available right now at Meyer and Frank, all stores.
KGW-TV, Channel 8 Portland and Tualatin.
Oh, honey, this is interesting. It's a list of semi-precious gemstones and their relative hardness.
Oh, great. That'll come in handy in the game. Terrific.
Yeah. Hi. Oh, John, Nancy, you made it. Come here, give me your coat.
Okay, the game's all set up. Come on, we're ready to play.
Oh, yeah, we're going to play that game.
Oh, yeah, Trivial Pursuit. Well, I got to warn you, we've only played it once, so don't expect much from us.
Oh, that's okay. It's fun even for beginners. You'll catch the hang of it.
Right.
Why don't you two sit over there,
okay.
And I'll sit right there, and Kevin, you just stay in your lucky chair.
Oh. All right. Oh,
this board is beautiful. What is it, wood?
Yeah, actually, it is wood. We wore out the three regular boards we had already, so Kevin made one in his workshop.
Holy cow! I didn't realize you were such hardcore fans of the game. You just played all the time.
Oh, I wouldn't say all the time.
Sometimes we have to go out and get groceries.
Well, let's start. Guests roll first.
All right. One.
Okay.
Science and Nature.
Science and Nature. Okay, brass is an alloy of what two metals?
Copper and zinc?
Yeah, that's right, see?
Great.
You're great.
Now what, we roll again, right?
Yeah, well, ordinarily you would, but why don't we just alternate until you get
the
hang of it, okay?
Right.
Two. Sports and leisure.
Sports and leisure, sports and leisure. In what sport did Billie Jean King beat Bobby Riggs?
What sport? Honey?
No idea. I thought you'd know.
Oh.
Really? You're kidding. You don't know? Tennis.
Tennis? Oh, I wouldn't have got that in a million years. Okay, right. Your turn again.
Oh, two. One, two. Entertainment.
Entertainment. Okay. Who played the chief on Get Smart?
Ed Platt.
Very good.
Great.
Very good. You two have an act for this game, don't you?
Yes.
Okay, we're already behind here. We better get going.
Okay. Three.
Three, sorry. I'm so nervous. I can't
history.
Think. History, history. Oh. What do the initials FDR stand for? FDR.
Forest Ranger. Forest Ranger?
No, it's FDR.
Ah.
Wait.
Yeah, okay.
I will go with it.
Yeah, all
right. Go.
Forest Ranger?
No, seriously. Are you serious? Oh, well, you won't believe what they have here. Franklin Delano Roosevelt.
Oh, sure. Franklin Delano Roosevelt. Real famous historical figure. You read about him every day, don't you?
A couple more like that, and we may as well quit. Okay. Let's go again.
Three. One, two, three. Geography.
Okay.
Geography. Okay, in what state was the OK Corral?
Arizona.
You two have the answer for everything, don't you? All right, let me roll this time. You're a jinx. Okay. Three. Okay, science and nature.
Mm-hmm.
what animal can generate up to 600 volts of electricity?
Whoa. They just don't let up, do they? 600 volts,
Well, it'd have to be a dog of some kind.
Okay, well, go with it, because I sure don't know.
Okay, what are those things they have in Alaska? Huskies.
Yeah.
I think that was a bad question. Let me look for another. Science and Nature, wasn't it?
Okay.
Who was the first man to set foot on the moon?
Oh!
Do you know the answer?
First man on the moon.
No, not right off the top of my head, I don't.
Well, then what the hell good are you?
Well, don't say that, me.
Okay, first man on the moon. It's,
Ed McMahon.
No. The other guy.
Charlton Heston.
They have something different written here.
You're kidding.
Wait.
I don't believe this.
I asked the question wrong. Who was the first man who was president of the United States?
First man to be president. Couldn't be Carter.
Wait a minute. Let me see that card. Oh, Science and Nature, you just made that up. So you think we're so stupid that we couldn't even answer the right questions. Is that it?
Wait a minute, Ken. I don't think that's fair. You know, we were just...
No, you wait, Mrs. Einstein. I'm very sorry that we don't have atomic brains like you two. Please try to forgive us for not getting every question right. We don't have your vast intellect to draw on.
Come on, it's only
a
game.
Pardon me, Professor, for boring you with my brainless chatter.
Honey, I think we should go. Yeah, go.
Yeah, get out of here. Come on. So smart, why don't you take this dumb game with you, too? Huh? Go on. You can have this. Come on, take it. Just take it. Take the game. Damn it. Take the game.
Honey, do you think maybe we're not as smart as we thought?
Well, no way. You couldn't believe those questions. I mean, FCR. What the heck is that?
Hi. My name is Maggie, and I'm one of the new kids you see around the show. I grew up in New York City, and by the time I was 13, I had already decided what I wanted to be. I wanted to be a black cheerleader.
My name's Yolanda, and I'm a Leo, and I can do it. That's right, I said it. That's right, I meant it. That's right, I'm here to represent it.
My name's Chantrell, and I'm a Libra, and I can do it. You're gonna lose, we're gonna win. You're gonna lose so bad, your head is gonna spin.
What you are about to see is the official video of the 1984 Summer Olympics.
What do you mean you shouldn't be here? Here is a light.
and you're a muff. Aren't you a muff, Doris?
Well, I am, sort of, I guess.
What do you mean, I guess? You are a moth. Don't be ashamed to be a moth. Say, I am a moth. Lock up your sweaters. The moth is coming. Right.
Oh, I can't.
Why, Doris? Why?
I don't know. I've always sort of been taught to be ashamed of my mothness. My mother tried to pass us off as butterflies. But my dad was real proud to be a moth. He used to say, you'll never see me sucking on a petunia.
Those are wise words. Come, Doris. What happened to him?
Oh, he's on the windshield of a Ford Bronco. That is, until they squeegeed him off.
Oh, then you must dance, Doris. Come, dance with me. Oh,
I'll try. What was that?
That was a June bug. They are crazy. Come, Doris, dance.
No.
Yes, you can dance like this. Watch me. Ah, hoppa. Yes. Mosquitoes, they are terrible this year. Ah, he, ah, oppa!
I want to thank Raoul, Julia, Randy Newman, and of course, Dave, Buck, Val, Maura, Maggie, and the Dynamic Breakers.
Yeah. Later on The Tonight Show, starring Johnny...
and Abney Coleman star...